Hello everyone. People often ask, what is the best FPV flight simulator? And I think a better question to ask is, what is your favorite FPV flight simulator? Today I'm going to talk a little bit about FPV flight simulators and talk about one in particular that is my favorite that you've probably never heard of before. So I'm sure most of you have heard of the popular FPV flight simulators like Liftoff, Velocidrone, DRL, DCL, FPV Freerider, and too many others to name them all. Well, while those are all great flight simulators, and in most cases well worth the cost, I'm not here to talk about those today. What I am going to talk about today, though, is the little-known flight simulator that currently goes by the name of Curry Kitten FPV Simulator. I believe Curry Kitten, who's the guy developing the software, I think he's got a little bit of help, but mostly it's just him. He's still looking for a different name for this program, and it was originally called the Curry Kitten Quad Simulator, but I think he's kind of branched off and gotten more generic and thinking that maybe you can fly planes and other things as well. So I think for now he's going with the name of the Curry Kitten FPV Simulator for now. So actually, now that I think about it, he could probably add the ability to drive ground vehicles first-person view as well. That could be interesting if you combine that with the network options that I'll get to a little bit later. So why is this currently my favorite FPV flight simulator? Well, the first thing is just that it's free. And it's really hard to beat a free FPV flight simulator. And if you're just getting started with FPV and you want to dip your toes in the water, using a free simulator is exactly what you're looking for. But that's obviously not unique. There are other free simulators out there. I think even the goggle manufacturer Orca has come out with a free FPV flight simulator in just the past few weeks. But it is one of the features that I do like about this simulator is that it is free. Secondly, I like that you don't have to have the best gaming computer on the planet to run the simulator. Some of the others require some pretty beefy computers, but this is not one of them. It seems to run pretty decently on all sorts of hardware. Unfortunately, most of the flight simulators out there do run on both Mac and PC, but not all of them do, especially as some of the other free ones tend to be PC only. Which makes sense if you're making some free software. It's easier to develop for just one platform and not worry about making it work cross-platform like that. But in this case, Curry Kitten has managed to make this work on Mac, PC, and on a Linux computer. So what else makes this simulator so special? Well, the first most interesting feature that Curry Kitten added to the simulator that I just love is the beach ball. I think the way he tells the story is that he was messing around with the early version of the simulator and he was putting in some objects and forgot to attach them to the ground or something like that, and he bumped into it with his drone, well, simulated drone, and it moved. And so he had the idea of putting a beach ball into the simulator that you can crash into and push it around all over the map. And I can't really explain it, but I find this simple addition to be so much fun. And it really helps to give you something to practice learning how to chase and hit and target. And it just lets you have fun while learning how to fly at the same time. But he didn't stop there with all the cool, unique features. Another thing that the simulator has that I don't think exists yet in any other flight simulator is the ability to chase moving objects, to chase other vehicles, basically. So if you turn on this feature, you can add some cars or a plane to the environment and practice chasing them all over the place. Car chasing has sort of become a staple of the FPV freestyle community lately, especially drift car chasing, but just chasing things in general. And being able to practice that in a flight simulator is a really great feature to have. And as you can see, you can adjust the number of cars, you can adjust where they drive throughout the map, you can adjust how fast they go. It just gives you a bunch of options so you can set it up for the kind of practice that you're looking for. And another thing that I like about this simulator is that in just one single map, you can dive city buildings, you can fly down mountains, you can fly through the trees, you can dive wind turbines, and you can even fly in and out of an abandoned building. And like any good beta software, he is constantly updating it and adding new features all the time. And in just the past week or so, he's even introduced the ability to fly with other people in a networked mode. And in this mode, while he was playing with it, he discovered like real life, it's really hard to see the drones flying around out there and chase them. So there's a couple of options where you can make the quads bigger than they normally are so they're easier to see, and you can add trails behind them so you can see where they are and chase them around a lot easier. And another great thing about this networked option is that when you're flying with other people, you can kind of make up a game to play, because there's gates you can go through, and there's a beach ball, and you can fight over the beach ball, try to push it through the gates. I don't know. You can come up with all kinds of creative uses for that. And I think hopefully he continues to develop this further and pretty much design a whole game just around this concept. So sort of think about like Rocket League, but you're flying with drones instead. Or imagine in the future if you can have some people flying FPV planes while others are driving cars and others are flying drones, and they're all in the same map and the same network simulator. That sounds like that could be a lot of fun to me, especially if they're all fighting over control over a giant beach ball in the middle of the map, or who knows, something like that. I'm sure people can come up with all kinds of creative ideas there. So one question I hear all the time, especially from new people in this hobby, is that what flight simulator is the best? Well, there's no perfect answer to that, because what is best really depends on what you're trying to get out of the flight simulator. Some flight simulators are better for race practice. Possibly Velocidrone might be one of the better ones for that. Liftoff's still pretty good at that too, but others are better for freestyle practice. And I think kind of that's sort of the point of this simulator, is that he wanted it to be really good for just having fun flying around freestyle. And if you want to be a pro pilot for DRL, well, then obviously you're going to have to practice in the DRL flight simulator, because that's where they do their DRL tryouts. But in my opinion, if you're new, be sure to give this simulator a try. Since it's free, there's no reason not to. And also, if you are checking out the other flight simulators, don't forget that most of them are available on Steam, and Steam will let you try out games for a limited time, and if you don't play them too long or don't own them for too much time, you can return them for a full refund. So that's another great way to test them out, see if you like them, and really the purpose of that is to make sure that your computer is strong enough to handle those flight simulators. Anyway, I hope by watching this video you're able to learn a little bit about this new simulator and give it a try. As usual, the links you need should be in the description below. And have fun. Maybe I'll see you in the simulator later.